everybody. It's Brandon from Branch 860 here in Pittsburgh. Today I'm going to be doing a prospect survey that I like to use to show customers what they're already spending to wash a load of dishes. I found a person here that's allowing me to use their kitchen. They're using a competitor of ours, so I'm going to walk you guys through the process of how I do this. The first thing you want to do is make sure that the machine has been run a few times. What that's going to do is that's going to make sure that we're getting the chemicals all pumped up into the machine so there's no air bubbles or anything. And it's going to also have the machine fill to the water level that it always does. You're always going to want to make sure that you have on your nitrile gloves and safety glasses. And the machine we're working on today is basically an ADS. It's a manufacturer machine that our competitors purchased to use for their systems. So what I did was I ran the machine once while we were getting things started to bring the water level up to where it would typically be. The first thing I do to start my process to keep it moving smoothly, because I don't want to tie their kitchen up a whole lot, is I take a pressure test. I made this gauge off of some parts that we can link in a comment section or something like that. It's just a pressure gauge and some discharge hose and a hose clamp. What I do is I disconnect the lower wash arm. Make sure that all the jets are clear. If one of the jets or two of the jets are clogged, it's going to change the pressure rating because it's going to be restricted. So I take off the end plug, put the hose over the end of the wash arm. This can sometimes be a pickle. That went well. Slide my hose clamp down over, and I want to hose clamp the arm and the hose together. Now what I want to do is put my arm back in the machine. And bring my pressure gauge on the outside. Just by starting the machine, it's going to kick the pump on and it's going to show us the pressure reading of the machine that we compete with. So our machine typically washes at 22 PSI. When I say typically, I mean that's where it's at, 21 and a half to 22 and a half. So when I close the door, it's going to pulse up. So you can see that this machine's washing right around 12 pounds of pressure. Pretty much I stopped the test right there. So we have a 12 pound wash pressure on this machine. Now all I do is undo my hose, put my end plug back in, and I'm gonna be ready for my next step. The next step that I always do is test how much water's in the machine. So the standing water level in here is where this machine fills to constantly. I always find something in the restaurant that's just laying around, whether it be a butter knife or a fork, and I mark the water level. If you could come in and see that, I just mark where the water level rests at, and what I want to do is I drain out all of the water. I just pull the drain plunger up, make sure all the water's out, and I have a couple buckets of water sitting here ready. Each of these is just a graduated cylinder with a gallon of water in each of them. I'm not sure how many I'm gonna need, but so I let the drain ball close and I just pour this water in 1 gallon at a time, slowly so that I don't slop up and move my indicator. So that's 1 gallon. There's 2 gallons of water. So the water's splashing around a little bit, but we're right near the indicator that we put in there, which this machine's using roughly around 2 gallons of water. The AutoClore single pass A5, same as this, would be 1 gallon of water per wash cycle. So they're using 2 gallons of water to produce 12 pounds of pressure, where our machine uses 1 gallon of water to produce 22 pounds of wash action. If people are having result issues or anything like that, those two things can really change a customer's costs for sure by reducing rewash and reducing the volume of water. The third thing I do, and you always want to make sure you have your safety glasses on for this, is I test the water, I test the chemical dosages that are going into the machine each cycle. So we're already into the wash cycle now. So I just flip the switch back on and let it finish through the first portion of the cycle to where the sanitizer and the rinse additive are going to dispense. Through this portion of the cycle, I like to listen to all the sounds I can hear. You can hear the wash pressure. You can hear the drain operation, the fill kick on. You can hear the fill flush end. You want to make sure that the drain is opening and closing in good timing with the way that the water is kicking on and kicking off. If the machine is, the drain's open and it's filling with water for 3 or 4 seconds, that's a lot of wasted water and a lot of time that we're missing out of our 90-second wash cycle. That could also be something that results in result issues. So right now the machine's draining that 2 gallons of water out. It started the refill before the water went out. That's good. So I know, and we all know, that as soon as the drains end, we're gonna be pumping our sanitizer and rinse additive in. So what I do is I remove the line from the machine, and some machines have the input down here, some have it up here. You just wanna be safe when you're messing with it. And if you see that it looks like there could be a leak or something, sometimes it's easiest to just snip the cable tie and get your chemical coming right out of the squeeze tube. It's not necessary in this case. These machines are really easy to get to. So I turn the machine back on. We're filling the machine. The sanitizer is going to start pumping in a second here. Sanitizer starts going in. And we're just watching the sanitizer level go up. This is a graduated cylinder. You could use a medicine cup from your allergy medicine or whatever. I found that my children's medicine has markings about like this on it. But this has 5, 10, and 12.5 milliliter markings on it. This machine's using about it's right in between 5 and 10, so I'm gonna call it 7.5 milliliters of sanitizer. So we start another wash cycle, and in this case, we're gonna catch the detergent. So we pull the detergent line out and run our next cycle. We're trying to do this in as quick a time as possible, so learning the times to catch and test different things can really shorten the amount of time it takes to do this process. Once again, it's about 7.5, 8 milliliters of detergent being pumped into this machine. What we want to know from our customer, if they've allowed us to get this far in the process and they are concerned about what they're paying, we're going to need the pricing that they're paying for their detergent, sanitizer, and rinse. Typically, it's in a 5-gallon bucket, and I'm going to tell you how to break that down in just a second. Each of the buckets have 18,925 milliliters that fill up that bucket. What we do to find out how much they're paying is take their cost divided by that 18,925. We're gonna catch that rinse additive real quick. We're gonna take that 18,925 divided by the cost that they have. That's gonna give us cost per milliliter times however many milliliters they're using. So they're using right around 4 milliliters of rinse additive. So the way we're going to break that down is we're going to use the 18,925 milliliters per container. This customer is paying $130 for their detergent. So we'll take 135 divided by 18,925 milliliters per pail. That will show you the amount they're paying per milliliter in that container. To find out the cost per wash, we'll take that 7.5 milliliters they were using and multiply that by the number we came up with, which will show us a penny value of how much the cost for detergent is every time they run the machine. You'll do that the same with the sanitizer and rinse additive also. As far as the water is concerned, I like to put a penny value on it as well. In the city of Pittsburgh, commercial properties pay around 2¾ cents a gallon for the water triangle, which is to purchase the water, heat the water, and dispose of it. With this machine using twice as much water, or an extra gallon, as our machine uses, we can show the customer that they're spending an extra 2.5 cents every time they run the machine, which will tack on to the cost that they're paying for the chemicals they're using as well. With all those things that we learned today on the wash pressure, we can show the customer that the difference between our machines is not just that it's going to be new and shiny. We're bringing twice as much wash pressure nearly to cleaning the dishes so that they don't have to pre-wash or have rewash issues. By reducing the amount of water that's in the machine, we're gonna save the customers on their water, heating, and sewage bill. And by showing them what they're actually paying for their chemicals that they're buying. They're typically getting them off the food truck or from a third-party vendor, and they're just ordering them when they order their food, so they aren't quite sure what it costs per load to run it. So we're able to break that down and show them every time they close that handle what it costs to run a load of dishes. When we break that down and show them our cost, we're able to show them an absolute difference in the value that they're receiving currently and what AutoClore is going to bring to the table. I hope this video has been helpful and you guys can utilize this to show prospects out in the field a value to using AutoClore. I want to show them our attention to detail and how we look at the system back here. We're not just washing dishes, we're a business partner. We want to save them money. We're not always the best option for everybody, but if people want the best that the company and the industry has to offer, AutoClore is always going to be the best option. We're going to come back here and take a good look at everything and really fine tune everything to give them the best results in the shortest amount of time that we possibly can. So going into each prospect with the idea that we're able to show them this is going to be a great way to benefit our what we do for our customers and how we show them what we're capable of doing. So I hope this has been a big help. I hope this can help everybody. And see you at President's Club.